I realized I was missing these one-on-one chats with my team when they needed it the most. And the best way, not just to keep your team around, but to keep everyone happy and to keep your work culture going well, is knowing what's actually going on in people's lives and helping them. G'day everyone, welcome back to another episode of Level Up. We are back in a very hot shed this afternoon, but we've got another cracking guest for you, and I can't wait to tell you more of his story. So we're starting to get a few repeat people come back and ask to be on their podcast again. And when this particular guy said to me, hey, I'd love to come back on, and he discussed with me what he'd like to talk about, I was like, fuck yeah, we've got to do this. The guest we have on for you this afternoon is Michael from NMR Design. How are you, mate?
Good, mate. Good. Thanks for having me back.
Mate, I'm so glad you said to me you wanted to come back and do this.
I'm very happy to hear it. I was glad you'd give me more time. I appreciate it.
Yeah. So look, I take my hat off to Michael. So look, we've got a mutual client that MR Design's done some design work for, and they've gone down the road of a couple other builders, and they've come to us, and we're now going through our pack process. And anyway, long story, got Michael out on site, and we had a site meeting with the clients and talked through the project, and looks like that job's going to be moving forward later in the year. But Michael and I got talking, Michael actually rang me after the meeting and reached out and said, I wouldn't mind coming back on the podcast, mate. I've listened to your podcast, and I fucking should have talked more when I was on there last time. And
yeah.
I take my hat off to him because he wants to talk about the struggles. So like we talk about all the time, social media, Instagram, Facebook, all the stuff, like everything looks really good on face value.
Yep.
And the reason I take my hat off for Michael this afternoon is he's come here to be vulnerable. He wants to talk about his struggles with anxiety and depression.
Last time it was great to talk about how good things are going and how the business has grown so much in the last 6 years. But I left feeling like I was just giving that same image that our Instagram does of, you know, success and doing well. But the truth is I've struggled with mental health the last 7 years. I've been on antidepressants. And 2 years ago was probably the hardest time I've ever gone through in my entire life. And that was purely because of the business and burning myself out. And I just felt like I should have brought that up more and talked about it, because it's so important that we actually talk about that. Because, I mean, as we know, especially men, it's such a big issue. Now I'm a designer. I'm not no tough man on sites, you know, lifting heavy weights and everything. But, you know, I'm still a man with a daughter and a wife and financial responsibilities.
Yeah, well, congratulations, mate, because you've had your daughter since you were here last time.
Yeah, mate, so 7 months old. She is everything. Completely changed my perspective on life, but testing my wife's patience constantly. So I come home to a pretty stressful household, but, mate, she's perfect. She's everything we wanted.
Yeah. So, mate, look, I think this is unbelievable, because, like, anxiety, depression is prevalent in our industry or in everyday life. Like, everyone has such busy lives now, and it's very easy to get taken over and feel like you're the only one dealing with stuff. Yeah. So.
Well, I think the biggest issue is that, especially with social media these days, we look up to the big boys like Grayer or developers that I inspire to be, and we're constantly judging our own lives against an imperfect picture. It's not the real picture of what's really going on. So, you know, I just felt after our last chat that I should come on and be honest about what it's actually been like behind the scenes, so that people listening, your audience listening, know that it's not easy. And we all go through these struggles, but I've learned how to cope. And because of my struggles, I've become a much more compassionate person. And I've been able to help so many more people, whether that's in my team or my friends or even just randoms reaching out. I've been able to help so many more people because I went through that struggle.
Yeah, mate, I think the picture you just painted is really important. Like we had young Braden from Zephyr Industries in here last week recording a podcast.
He's got a bloody awesome house up at Newport.
Oh, mate, I believe he's just set the benchmark in Brisbane, the level and the dollar value of the homes that he's built. But, like, mate, he was telling us, and again, it's all perception. Like, you see his Instagram, you see what he's doing, and it looks incredible. But, like, he was telling us how when he bought his first house, he was a third-year apprentice, and he got to a point where, because he was working with his old man, he had to ring his old man and say, hey, when do I turn fourth year? I can't afford to pay me mortgage. Yeah, I need some more money.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then even as it progressed and he started getting bigger jobs, there was homes that he was living in that he had to sell to feed the business to keep things going.
And I know.
Look, at the end of the day, he's in an incredible position and he's done very well.
Yes.
But everybody goes through struggles.
Absolutely. And I think it's important for people that are up and comers that they realize that it's not as easy as it seems, and it's okay to struggle.
Yeah.
We all do. And we seriously need to be talking about this more, you know, like the whole thing of it's not weak to speak. It really isn't. And I've become very comfortable with talking about mental health, especially since my business partner passed away, you know, because he mentally was not in a good place at the end.
Yeah.
And having him as a mentor in my life and then losing him and then going through my own mental health battle has made me realize that I need to do more to help people out there that are going through the same. And it's just about paying it forward. And that's all I ask them that they do in return.
Yeah. And look at, like you just said, it's okay. Struggling and having difficult days and dealing, like I tell people, like, I battle with demons every day. And some days it's just a quick kick in the ass and they're gone. And other days it's like the whole day is just like, fuck no, I can do that. Shit, don't listen to it. Like, go away.
Yep. Like, what people don't realize is that behind a successful business, I doubt myself and all my decisions 90% of the time.
Yeah.
I come in some days like today where I'm just blaring ready to go and I've got a clear picture. And then I hit a pretty big speed bump today where one of my designs was over budget, which has just been the story the last 2-3 bloody years. But, you know, we all go through this. And so I wanted to talk about what it went through.
Yeah.
Our biggest strength is our biggest weakness. And I'm an extremely driven guy. And I have what's diagnosed as high functioning anxiety. I push myself beyond my limit and I crash and burn. And the problem with that is that pushing myself, so many people around me become dependent because I want to be a leader. And so many people lean on me and I don't lean back on anyone, or I try not to. My poor wife has copped it a bit. And I just got to a self where I burn myself out. And my problem is my wife and I have this thing where we're scared of being mediocre. And that's why I'm so driven. That's why I'm pumping this business until we're the next Sean Lockyer, apart from it being my passion.
Yeah.
So what happened 7 years ago, as a backstory, the first time I'd never had anxiety. My younger brother went through terrible mental health issues in high school due to bullying. And I was never that kid. I was always just go happy and a lucky kid. I had a great upbringing. I'm very lucky. The one thing though that I do want to talk about was, you know, I have a loving father, but he's military and he didn't understand what Grant and I were going through, and it actually made things harder for us.
Yeah.
So I also want to talk today about how people around someone struggling should actually act around them and act towards them, because that makes or breaks.
Sorry to interrupt, guys, but we've got to thank our sponsors, because without them, we can't keep delivering you this incredible podcast. So massive shout out to DPS Constructions, Quotees, Live Life Build, and 44 Gallon Films. Make sure you go and check those guys out, support them so that we can keep delivering you this incredible podcast. I think that, like, that, mate, that was a big one for me as well. Like, and I had an incredible upbringing as well. And man, my parents couldn't have done any more for me. They went out of their way, but there is a bit of an old school, you weren't allowed to express your feelings, or if you did, correct. You're what's wrong with you? Yeah. Harden up, stop crying. Well,
my old man's my best mate, but he thought going to a psychologist was terrible because it was going to be a red mark on your resume for the rest of your life.
Yeah.
And mate, seeing a psychologist was the best thing I ever did.
Mate, just to go a little bit off topic here,
sure.
And I don't know if I've ever told anybody this, but
come your deep dark secrets.
Nah, so mate, in some of my worst, I finished my time, started doing some subby work, and within the first 2 years, dug myself a hole, or building for ourselves, and had these couple of clients that, looking back now, it was all my fault. I just didn't do anything right.
You didn't know how to manage clients and manage the work.
Well, man, you didn't do a contract or anything. But long story short, these had two clients in a row. I was 23, 24. Like thought I was kicking goals, thought I had heaps of money, I was buying rental properties and shit. Like I had a lot of people working for me, and these two clients just didn't pay, and it affected my cash flow. It affected everything. My mental health went downhill very
quickly.
Can't
stop thinking about it.
And so I couldn't sleep.
Yeah.
And so I actually went to the doctor, and I just wanted to talk to someone.
Yep.
And so I had this conversation, and I actually left there feeling pretty good. And he's like, you know, it's okay. Like we can put you on tablets. So I don't want tablets. I really just.
And I'd like to get into that. That's what they do straight away.
Yeah. But anyway, long story short, mate, the next year when all my business insurances were due,
yep,
my insurance company dropped me.
Right.
Because the doctor had done a report and said that I was a risk of suicide.
I couldn't get life insurance 6 months ago because I'd gone and spoken to a doctor and admitted that I use alcohol as a coping mechanism.
Yeah.
So I couldn't get life insurance for my daughter.
Yeah. So I couldn't get life insurance, but it also affected my business insurance because this doctor had written this thing down saying that I was a risk
and
of suicide.
How stupid is that? Instead of continuing your bad patterns and your bad habits, you were actually going and seeking help.
Yeah.
That's definitely something wrong with the system.
Like, how fucked is that?
It is. It is.
And yeah, to be honest, I actually don't know if I've ever told, like, apart from my wife and Sharon that works in the office. Mm-hmm. I don't know if there's anyone else that would ever know about that because I was actually ashamed to talk about it.
Yep.
Because if I whinged anyone about it, I was admitting that I had mental health issues.
Yep. And one of the reasons that I had to talk to my business partner and my wife about coming on and doing this was because is this going to reflect poorly on me and my business because I've struggled? And that right there is the problem.
Yeah.
The fact that we have this stigma with mental health that we can't talk about it.
Yeah.
So yeah, mate, speaking of doctors, the first thing they'll try and do is put you onto pills. What a lot of people don't realize is the next 4 weeks you go through some terrible side effects. And that's what I went through 2 years ago, which I'll get a bit more into.
Go back to 7 years.
Yeah, sure. So. Okay. So where it started for me was 7 years ago before MR, I was working in commercial drafting. I had a great boss, but I was just learning nothing. After 2.5 years, I was just doing the same thing. And I'm someone who has to keep learning and keep progressing. And I just out of nowhere started having all these anxiety attacks, just freaking out and think, for people who haven't had anxiety, it's hard to imagine, but just imagine you're worrying about situations all the time, okay? And now 95% of these situations will never happen, or they'll be easier to deal with than you think they're going to be. I went through that, and my wife, who was at the time my partner, almost left me over it because it changed me. You know, I was constantly in my own head. But then I started MR, and you know, Ryan was unwell, and that became, you know, MR and Ryan became my focus. And going to MR, starting MR and working for myself completely changed it. And I came good again. Then Ryan died 3.5 years ago. And then COVID happened and we had a massive boom in our industry, as you know. And we went from 5 to 10 staff very quickly. Now, back then, what, two-ish years ago, it was Hayden and I with 8 juniors. Now we have more seniors than we have juniors. So you can imagine I was doing everything. And I was working 60, 70 hours a week. I was just burning myself out. And I did this for about a year to the point where I just burn out and I could not come back. I could not recover. I got to the point where I couldn't get up out of bed in the morning. I did, but the second I woke up, I thought about it. And mate, to be honest, it was a really, really hard time. A lot of people really worried about me. You know, I didn't get as far as considering suicide, which I've had friends get down to, but it was on that track, okay? I'm so lucky I had the support I have around me. Now, I hid this. You know, I went to work and I hid this from my team as long as I could, and I hid this from my clients because I didn't want them to think it would impact their projects.
Well, mate, I'm pretty sure around that, thinking back 2 years, that's probably when I'd probably come across you, and I think we might have had a couple of meetings and...
Yep.
Yeah, you definitely didn't portray yourself as someone that was dealing with mental health.
No, issues. Well, I'm very good at not acting. I'm just, it's all on the surface. And, you know, the old saying, be nice to people because you have no idea what they're going through.
Yeah.
It's completely true.
It's one of my big things now is you just, like, at any point in any day, you never ever know what someone else that, whether it's a delivery man, it's a team on site, it's a contractor, it's a client. Like, everybody is dealing with shit.
Absolutely, mate. But it got to the point where people were so worried about me. You know, my wife, like, she's just been everything for me. She's going through a bit right now with the baby, which is fair enough. We're a bit sleep deprived at the moment. A man can only do so much with his useless nipples, as she keeps telling me. But yeah, I got to that point where I just couldn't do it anymore, and Hayden told me to take a week off, and I came back and I was still burnt. And I went, oh shit, I'm at the point now where I can't even recover from this. And I thought I was never going to get out of it. But, you know, in the shower in the morning, just fucking having to hit myself on the chest and say, you can do it. It's all right. You can do it. You can do it. You can do it. And in between every meeting, try not to have anxiety attacks. And if you haven't had anxiety attacks, there's nothing fun about it. Okay. But I'm here 2 years later. My life is great. And I have coping mechanisms.
So, sorry, mate, to cut you off. So, because I think there's people out there that are having anxiety attacks and they dismiss it and they don't know. Like,
oh, that's true.
So what?
Okay, the signs.
Obviously,
first, you have a lot of stress in your life. A lot of people might resort to things like smoking and not realize that they've just calmed themselves down. And that's called a distraction. You're not defusing the situation. All you're doing is prolonging it. And what I was doing at nighttime was I was drinking not a bottle of wine, but I was having a few reds every night whilst working because I had so much to do. And all it did was make me feel worse in the morning when I still had heaps to do. Anxiety can come in very different forms, but for me, trouble breathing, tight chest, your blood pressure spikes. You also start to, if you're really in it, you focus on one point. Yet something you have to realize that when you're feeling like that, you have to release your jaw and your shoulders, and you have to open your eyes. Okay. So what I mean by that is open your vision. Okay. Because that will stop the stress. It pretty much, it's your body. And if you fight it, if you tell your body, nah, get over this, it'll get worse.
Yeah.
So My younger brother, he went through some terrible times, but he now does disabled care and is a high school teacher, and he's compassionate because of what he went through. And he taught me anxiety is like, this is the best tip I can give if you think you're having anxiety tips. Imagine a fork in the ground. If your anxiety, that fork starts to sway. If you start pushing back, it's going to sway more and more and more. So the more you push back, the more it's going to sway and the worse it's going to get. And then you're going to have a full-blown anxiety attack where it's going to take you an hour or two to calm down. What you need to do is accept it. You need to say to yourself, I'm anxious, and that's okay. If you accept it and then you learn coping mechanisms, it disappears really quickly. It can honestly make or break your day.
Yeah. Oh, definitely, mate. I know heaps of times where I'd get so anxious that I'd sit in my truck and I'd have to ring up and make an excuse to cancel the meeting because I couldn't go.
There were a few days I didn't show up to my last job and I was sitting in my car in tears.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So I want to talk about how I got through that time.
Yeah.
Because the reason I'm being vulnerable today is for that one person out there that might be going through a similar situation. And I want to say as well, if they want to reach out, they are more than welcome to reach out to you, and you are more than welcome to push them onto me, okay?
Yeah, man, that's unreal.
After being in that dark space and worried about where my life is going, I'm more than happy to take the time in my life to speak to someone in that same situation.
Yeah.
Because I found that people who haven't been through it can't actually really help. You need someone who understands what you're going through. When Ryan was having anxiety attacks about dying, Hayden couldn't assist like I could. And that's not on him. That's just purely because he's not an anxious person. And he's got his life together a bit more stable than I did.
which is okay. We're all different.
Oh, absolutely. Oh, we're all different, mate. We're all born extremely different. So I went and saw a psychologist. And I can't explain the tingles and relief that came off me as I walked out. The first meeting, I cried my eyes out. And I'm not afraid to admit that. I'm sure many men have done the same, okay? But then the second one, and then to the sixth one. So the government does 6 to 10 rebates. Go see your doctor. Don't let them put you on the pill straight away. It sounds like the birth pill. Don't let them put you on Lexapro straight away. That's what I'm on, okay? And I have been for 7 years. I think now I'm dependent where I don't know if I can get off it. I've tried and I've had terrible crashes. Go talk to someone first. Doctors have been great help, but the first thing they're going to do is try and put you onto that pill, okay? And you do become extremely dependent on it, and you also have 4 weeks of very bad side effects. go and talk to a psychologist. The best thing is, regardless of them being a trained professional and being able to pick apart what you're saying, it's someone who's not in your life. You don't have to, you can be completely honest. And it doesn't matter if it's your best mate or your wife, you still spin the story a little different because of how that person sees you.
And I think, I actually think a lot of people probably try to get help.
Yep.
And like you just said, like you bawled your eyes out. Like,
yep.
I believe there's a lot of people, like I believe I know some people that have gone and seen someone.
Yep.
And they're still telling a bullshit story that they feel better because they didn't let themselves get vulnerable and they haven't let it out.
Well, then you're not going to help yourself.
Yeah.
You're going to keep going through that same shitty pattern and live an awful lifestyle.
Yeah. Like it is completely okay to fucking spill your guts, let some tears out and fucking deal with all the shit.
Yep. So one of my best mates right now is having suicidal thoughts because he's burnt out from work and a lot's going on behind the scenes. And he's a country boy and he's a trade. And he called me on the way to the psychologist that I made him book, and he almost pulled out of it because he wasn't willing to be vulnerable, but I made him go. And whilst he hasn't seen anything yet, it takes a few sessions. I know he will, you know, and it feels good. It takes worry off my mind and people around him to know he's actually seeking help from someone who can properly help him.
Yeah. And mate, look, even if, like, we got a good relationship with the Trademark and the TX guys, like, mate, they're doing incredible things. Like the service they offer as well, like the free phone service, like it's not just a ring up, tell your problem, see you later. Like they actually come up with, I think it's an 8 or 10 step plan where they keep checking in with you and following up.
Oh, that's great
up.
To know. I've obviously just seen the shirts, but that's great to know that there's more to it.
What they do is insane. Yeah. But it's all talking. Like it's okay to talk.
Yeah, and I think we know that it's a bigger industry in your trade area than it is in the office world, I believe.
I think it's across the board.
Yeah.
I'm sure there's office people that hide in their cubicle and hide behind their computer. I do believe 100% like what the stats say, like our phones are just making this worse and worse.
Yeah,
like everyone is so
mate.
Addicted to just
like
flicking and flicking and flicking until you see something that interest you for 2 seconds and then flick.
Dopamine levels, it's terrible for us. Do you know David Goggins? He did a talk recently. I went and saw him and he spoke about that. And mate, I'm reading his book and his life is really messed up and he's been a massive inspiration. I've been in the gym every second day recently, which is good for me. I'll get to every
what's
day.
What's his book called?
He's got 2 books. The latest one is called Never Finished. He runs like 100-mile marathons and he did like 8 in 8 weekends, right? And this guy grew up in just terrible, not poverty, but abuse. And he was fat and big, and then he wanted to be a Navy SEAL. And now his mindset, mate, I can't even explain it. Look him up. He does a podcast with Joe Rogan. I've been listening to it whilst I work out. He's a perfect example of no matter who you are, you can change it and you can become incredible.
Yeah.
He is, mate. The other one I think is called Can't Hurt Me, something like that.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Shall I get into some coping strategies that I found? So,
Yeah, for sure, mate.
I made a list because I've been through this for 7 years now. And
so, let's go back. So you're saying you've been on these tablets for 7 years.
Yep.
So, and then you've said that your worst, like, situation was only like 2 years ago.
Yep.
So, like, they're quick to prescribe pills, aren't they?
Very.
Like, so you've been on pills for probably 5 years longer than maybe you had to be on them.
Yes. Probably even. I don't know if that's on me or if that's on the doctor.
Yeah.
Once I started MR, I probably should have got off it because that changed my life. I had purpose again. And that made me feel better. I actually tried getting off them 2 years ago when I was very busy because my wife was concerned and she has all right to be that I'm going to be dependent on this stuff forever. And I weaned off for months at a time. And this is what pretty much tsunamied on top of everything that was happening. This made me have my breakdown and I had to get straight back on them. They actually put me on more.
Yeah.
Yep. And I've been on more since. I don't mind talking about it because it helps me. And like my dad says, if I have to take a pill at the end of the day to be happier in life, what's it matter?
Yeah.
But I do worry that I'm completely dependent on these because when I tried weaning off, I was having terrible, like, lightheadedness, emotions, mate, all over the place, upset or angry.
Yeah.
Like, one of my team walked out during our team meeting to go to the toilet without asking. It's a bit rude, but I went off my head.
Yeah.
And I apologized to him, and I let my team know what I was actually going through. And with my team, I've actually built an office, my own little cubicle type office in the office, instead of being out in the workspace, because I realized I was missing these one-on-one chats with my team when they needed it the most. And the best way, not just to keep your team around, but to keep everyone happy and to keep your work culture going well, is knowing what's actually going on in people's lives and helping them. I'm very big on mental health days. If you're some boss who someone calls up and says, I'm not mentally doing well, and you force them to come to work, that's the wrong fucking attitude.
Yeah.
That you're not helping in any way.
Yeah.
I get you have a business to run, but it's a sick day. They should be allowed to use it for mental health days.
Yeah.
I've kind of rambled to the point where I forgot where I was leading,
mate,
to.
It's all good information. Like, yeah. We actually only had our first two. Like, no one had actually ever hit me up for a mental health day until last year, and we had two within a couple of month period.
Yep.
And like, I was like, mate, like, yeah. Didn't have any idea. Like,
yeah,
give us a shout if you want to have a chat. Like,
there haven't been many mental health days until recently. Living expenses is really affecting my team.
Yeah.
Most of them have asked us for pay rises, and it's been really quiet for us in residential. And we had a pretty scary 3 months, to be honest, along with every other designer in my competition I speak to. But we still helped out our team because we wanted to keep them, and we know it's going to come back. We know in a few months, like, we're really busy all of a sudden, and that shows the house in demand is there.
Yeah.
So whilst a lot of people aren't building because of interest rates, it'll come back. But I'll get to where what's happening with the business and where we want to take it.
No, well, tell us how you're dealing, mate. What have you learned to do to deal with this?
Okay, so there's a few. Obviously, the big one is, and I know this is a bit basic, but a healthier lifestyle. You have to stop diffusing with alcohol or drugs or whatever it is. Well, quitting smoking whilst you're going through this might not be the best advice. I did see my boss do that, and that was a bad idea. Honestly, mate, exercise is the best thing.
Yeah.
All my doctors and psychs have said there's nothing better. Just go for a walk. So I read this thing about your life force. It's your mind, your body, and your mind. Okay, so your mind, your body, and your soul. So I should not be doing yoga. So I was it pretty much, you need to pay attention to those three every day. So your mind is about calming yourself down. Your soul is about talking to yourself and where do you want to be going, and are you happy with things? And your body is obviously working out. I found that walking the dogs along Flinders Parade on the water, that did all three for me. So I started doing that every day.
Yeah. It's funny that like all of those, like taking that time, working on yourself, exercise and stuff.
Yeah.
It allows you to breathe.
It does, mate. It does, yeah.
Breathing is so important.
Yep. And my stress was work-related. My big problem was I didn't manage my clients. I learned this the hard way. I'm nicer than Hayden puts it, where I was calling, picking up calls and texting back at nighttime and on the weekend.
Mate, you can't do that.
No shit. And mate, I didn't know this.
Got to set business hours. Like, we're
correct.
Yeah. And like, well, again, like,
I could never turn off.
Yeah, you got to set business hours.
Yep.
Like, and
I realize
that. And when you set them, you got to stick to them. If like, yeah, and like, for me now, and look, I was the same. Like,
yeah,
and mate,
we all learned the hard way.
Yeah, we all learned the hard way.
Most of us,
like,
some are
something
smarter.
So simple as setting business hours and then sticking to it.
Yep.
Don't respond to calls, texts, emails.
Yep.
Is a game changer. Yep. And then if even like, to take it further, when someone wants to book a meeting.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone puts their priorities onto you.
Correct.
But you need to prioritize your priorities.
Yep.
So if someone wants a meeting with you,
yep.
It doesn't, I don't care
it
that
can
they
be
can meet
week.
Me next week.
It can be two
if
weeks.
If I can't meet for 3 weeks,
absolutely.
That's when I'll meet them.
I had to value myself more, my time and what I'm worth.
Yep.
Yeah, that's a big one. Managing clients, but also workload. when I met you, you were saying you got boys can push your prices, and that was good to hear. The problem was I was just taking everything and trying to, I was promising everything, mate. Jeez, I stressed my team out. I lost quite a few people 2 years ago. And I don't think it's because of my mental battle. I think it's because I stressed them out, because it would come up to a Friday and we'd have four things due because I promised the world. And so we've become a lot more selective. We went from winning 90% of our projects to 30%. Okay,
But
so.
they're better projects, they're better paying. I'm
Correct.
actually like
Making
I'm keen
this.
to see what your whole list is, mate, but I'm already picking up from the couple that you've already said that you've taken ownership.
Well, I had to, mate. I couldn't keep living the life I was living. I couldn't. I remember sitting down with Hayden, a bit upset, and Hayden was very big support for me during the time, whilst he didn't fully understand it. And I said to him, I can't keep living this life. I can't. I was too driven, mate, and I was trying to prove to everyone that I was the best and over please. You can still please people by setting your boundaries. And I've realized that. And by upping our prices and winning less work, we're now bringing through the same money.
High five,
I
mate.
know. When you came around and met us that time, we were already talking about it. But now we're doing half the work and making the same money, and our lifestyle is better. And you know what that means? That means that I give a better service to my clients, and I'm not rushing. I'm not rushing between 4 to 5 meetings a day.
The
I book one a day now.
I think the important part of that, mate, is that you're doing less work and you're making more money. And it's not that you've become more expensive, it's that you're actually getting paid what you're worth.
Correct.
Whereas
Absolutely.
before,
I valued myself.
you were just working for free.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, we have taken on cheap jobs to get ahead and build from decks up to multi-million dollar, but it was just getting to the point where I was too nice, mate. And my wife, she's a lawyer. She really taught me you got to stand up for yourself. And that's on my list too. You have to stand up for yourself. If people in your life are pushing you around, you have to stand up, otherwise it won't change. And my clients were really doing that to me because it was their priority, like you said. They don't care if I'm there Friday night till 9 o'clock. If they can get it today instead of Monday or Tuesday, they'll push you for it. You have to set your
And
boundaries.
as soon as you give them that little, as soon as you do it
As
once,
soon as you give it an inch, they take a mile.
they'll do it every. And so if your design process takes
Correct.
3 months, 6 months, 12 months, if you have that first meeting outside your work hours, or you go and meet with them, you let it go till 9 o'clock at night, they're going to expect that for the
Correct.
entire time that they deal with you and your business.
I used to work Saturdays. I don't allow it anymore. I have a life, and plus I have a kid at home and a wife to keep happy. So yeah, mate, that was the big ones. I mean, I had to change the problem. And the problem for me was being overloaded and working way too hard and not valuing my time. It was scary. When you're very You have to change your mindset. You have to go through that mental glass ceiling. It was scary for me to go out there and price higher and be like, shit, is the business going to fall over? But I had to trust what I was hearing, and it was the right decision.
Mate, you sell well, mate. Your product speaks for itself.
Yeah,
But
thank you.
so many people, and look, again, I consider I'm no different. I went through all the hard shit. And it's easy for me to sit here and say now, but I hope by you and I having these conversations and putting it out to the world that there is people listening that will take away from this and go, fuck, I need to do that.
That is the exact reason I'm here, is because I just don't want people to go through what I went through, when all you need to do is know a couple of things. It seems so easy on the other side, but at the time, mate, it was the hardest shit I've ever been through.
So what else you got on there, mate?
Okay, so that's obviously about the work side. I talked about seeing a psychologist, recognizing the signs early. Now, this is a big one. I felt an anxiety attack coming on the Christmas holidays just gone. I'm not afraid to talk about what triggered it. We were away on holidays at Kingscliff enjoying ourselves, and we're at Red Brekky, and this macho dude with his girlfriend kept checking out my wife and kept giving me death stares. And I'm not an alpha male, and I don't care to be like that. But it really got on my nerves, and it really affected me, right? And I didn't say anything, and we left. And then we were walking around for a couple hours around the shops, and my wife went and got a massage, and I realized, shit, I'm feeling the signs coming on. Now, those signs are you're thinking about it constantly. And like I said, I could feel my chest getting tighter, and my jaw was a bit clenched as well. And I could feel my blood pressure coming up every now and then. Mainly, I couldn't stop thinking about it. So what I did was, my daughter was a bit younger. I went and sat under a tree, and I did my breathing exercises. And now that might sound a bit silly, just breathing, but you had Justin Andrews on, and I had a chat with him following you guys as well. He's a great person and a good builder we've worked with for years. He takes it to the point of hallucinating. I have not gone that far.
Gotta try it, mate.
Yeah. DMT is pretty full on, natural DMT. So what I do is mindfulness meditation and breathing. Now, if anyone out there is struggling with anxiety, I really recommend you go to your app store right now and download an app called Headspace. The icon is a white background with an orange circle face. Now, what that is every morning for 10 minutes, you need to find a quiet spot. It doesn't have to be the morning. It just has to be, when the hell can you get 10 minutes of peaceful time? Wake yourself up 10 minutes earlier. It's worth it. And pretty much, I can't teach it like they can. You need to go through the full thing. But pretty much, it's sitting there, closing your eyes. We'll slow your breath first. Now, when you breathe, this is one that the psychs always teach. Don't breathe through your chest. You need to be breathing slower. You know this. Through your nose and feel your stomach rise, and then exhale twice as long. Now, do that a few times and you will feel yourself calm down. You'll feel it's your body. It's not all your mind. It's mainly your body.
Yeah.
And then
breathe through your belly.
Yep, absolutely. And a Buddha belly. Yeah. And then you close your eyes, and what you need to do, you can't stop the thoughts. That's something else you need to realize. You just have to change how you react to them. We are always going to have negative thoughts, but you can change. You have to train your mind to how you react to those thoughts. So mindfulness is closing your eyes and listening to what's around you, smelling what's around you, even feeling what's around you. And whilst this sounds silly, give it a go. Pay attention to your senses, and it grounds you.
It only sounds silly because we were brought up thinking all that shit was soft and
absolutely
hard and up. Like,
absolutely.
What are you doing that shit for?
I completely agree. And I feel silly doing it if someone sees me, but it helps me.
Yeah. Mate, I think go for your life. Like, get out and do it. It's incredible what breath work does.
Yep.
I did my first one-on-one session with Justin two and a half months ago.
Yep.
And mate, when it was done, I struggled to get up, and I literally had to sit on a chair and I cried my eyes for like 25 minutes.
You said you had some trauma that came up. That sounds scary to deal with, but you should deal with it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mate, I don't like saying it sounds silly, but like I could feel it moving out of me. And I still feel like I'm floating on a cloud. Yep. And that was 2.5 months ago.
Yep. Might have to give it a go. It sounds scary to push yourself, but if it makes you a better person and live a happier lifestyle, why wouldn't you?
Well, I think it just shows how powerful breath is.
It is. It really is.
Like breath, I think we take it for granted because it's just something we have to do to survive.
Yep.
But I agree. Like I've learned a little bit of this off Justin, but a lot of the books I've read in that as well. Like our lifestyles are so busy now that it's actually affecting the way we breathe. We're all mouth breathers now.
Technology's sped it up.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Actually, that's interesting you say that, because I'll say, like, my daughter, she's a nose breather. So, yeah, we probably are mouth breathers because we're just so bloody busy all the time.
Yeah. I remember when I was in my early teens, I had to get a plate and shit in my mouth because...
Yep.
They said that I shouldn't be mouth breathing, and mouth breathing is just normal.
Like,
everyone does it.
I was going to say as well, with that mindfulness, I went from about to have an anxiety attack to feeling great and back to normal and centered, and I could be that husband again that could enjoy his time with his wife, because my wife has suffered alongside me because I haven't been me, and I've been in my own head, and I haven't enjoyed those moments which are special and important. Our first holiday with our kid, so she's seen me really develop and go through it. And you need support around you. Whilst at times she didn't understand how to deal with it because she hadn't been through it, and this is what I wanted to talk about. People, anyone out there listening right now that has someone suffering in your life, you just need to show that you understand. You need to show your support. What you can't do is get frustrated with them, because all you're doing is flicking that fork, as I said. You're only going to make matters worse for them. And that can be hard. I remember when my brother was unable to eat for months because of his anxiety, and he would throw up some food. My dad would get very frustrated with him, and unfortunately that wasn't, that didn't help, you know, that wasn't the answer. So we'll see if I can knock these over. The way you speak to yourself. So I'm very hard on myself, and I think that just comes from who you are and your personality. You are your best friend. You need to speak to yourself in a better light. You need to say, mate, you're doing a great job. It's okay. Listen, you could have done that better, but we're all learning. You know, that was really big for me. And when I was late last year, getting a bit down on myself again, I noticed that. And so the more that you actually go through these hard times and learn to recover, the easier it becomes. I'll live with anxiety for my life, but it doesn't scare me anymore because I know how to react to it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mate, again, it's something I think is really important. Yeah. Like, no one... How often does someone come up and give you a pat on the back? Like, if you're not fucking giving yourself
especially
a pat on the back...
Especially not when you're the boss.
Yeah, like, exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
Absolutely.
Like, it's all good to go into your office or go on site and cheer up the team. How you going, boys? Great job. All this stuff. Like,
correct.
I'm really big on... Like, we all communicate through Slack. I'm really big just randomly in the afternoons or whatever. Hey, team, awesome job. Love your work. Keep
Me
it
too.
Up.
Yep.
I don't get it.
No.
I never get it.
No. And I don't get it from home.
I'm not saying I want to get it, but
no.
If you don't give yourself a fucking pat on the back, like, no one else will.
So I actually give myself a literal pat on the back.
Yeah.
After I've done well and when I get in the ute and I drive away, I actually pat myself. That was good. Good on you. You have to support yourself. And again, it sounds silly, but it'll make your life so much better if you can be vulnerable. And listen, you've been vulnerable by yourself. It's nothing like getting up here and talking about it. So if I can do this, everyone out there, they can help themselves.
Yeah.
Yeah. And anyone listening going through a hard time, you will get through it. I didn't think I would. And that's just because you're stuck in that moment, but you will. You just need to take it one day at a time. Yep.
Yeah.
I think that's it, mate. Yeah. Those are the big ones for me. Now, talking to my brother, there are many different techniques, and he taught me a few, and some will work better for you. Honestly, Google how to deal with my anxiety. There is plenty there.
So do you think the first one is like just forgetting about what everyone else thinks, forgetting about what you're trying to, or something you're trying, I think a lot of people are trying to be something they're not.
Sure.
And it's a lot of it's, especially now, is from social media stuff. But do you think the first one is actually just taking 5 minutes to sit on the end of the bed, have a good think and think, like, fuck, is this anxiety? Like,
yeah, I can't remember to when it first happened for me and how I realized it was anxiety. I think pretty much if you're having a panic attack, that's anxiety. That's an anxiety attack. I think my brother was the one who made me realize what I was going through. Just, I don't know, out of breath and just worked up. If you're having that, you're having anxiety. And if you do, the sooner you learn to cope with it, the better.
See, I never got the breath thing.
No.
Like, I never got tight in the
chest.
Everyone
gets different.
I never got the breath thing, but I would work myself up so much emotionally that, like I said, I would literally just end up pulled over, sitting in my truck, not doing anything, sometimes having a cry, and I would literally have to ring up and say, hey, something's come up, I can't
make a lie. Yeah. Mate, I was sick plenty of times during that hard time.
So I think it's going to be different for everyone. Everyone's going to have their own little thing, but I think recognizing that thing that's holding you back.
Yes, absolutely. I think the big thing is once you realize what you're going through is accepting it. There is nothing more important than I've learned about anxiety. You have to tell yourself, I accept I am this way, or I'm going through this right now. That's the best way you can work with it. Some people even name it. Some people name their anxiety Fred and be like, Fred's back again.
Yeah.
And that just helps you pull it into a third perspective. Oh, another thing that really helped me was when I was really in it, was looking down on myself from a third perspective. Now, I didn't take drugs. I didn't do natural DMT. But I just imagine you're looking down on yourself and think about, how is this person doing? That really helped me as well.
Yeah.
It's good to pull back and reflect.
Yeah.
So, get some exercise in you if you're struggling. Go for a walk. It sounds so simple. And I know it might be hard to get off the couch when you're drinking and you think that's the solution. But again, that's just a distraction. You need to diffuse it. Go for a walk.
Yeah. And look, it really is the simple things that make the big difference,
yeah,
isn't it?
Absolutely.
Like going for the walk,
Yeah.
doing the breath, giving yourself a pat on the
Yep.
back. Like
Yep.
again, like I think giving yourself on the back, giving yourself a pat on the back is
Yep.
a really good thing to do.
Yep.
And I'd recommend it to anyone. Like another thing I do is I just do a shout out in my truck, mate. Like I'll just
Yeah.
get in my truck, I'll start driving, I'll crank the tunes and just
Mate, sometimes I've had a bad meeting. I've got in the truck and gone, fuck, and just scream the anger out. Or then I've had a win and I get in the car and I drive away. I've just won a project I wanted and I'm like, yes, let it out. Let it out. You have to let out that emotion.
You gotta be proud.
That's the problem with the old traditional ways, that they just bottled it in and it came out in anger in different ways. Just get it out.
Anger, abuse, anxiety, depression. It's just bloody live life.
Absolutely.
Like be happy, enjoy, embrace it.
I'm sure there's people listening in a hard place and it sounds easier than it sounds harder than what we're saying. But once you get to the other side, you realize it is actually quite easy. You just have to get a better lifestyle and you have to stick to that routine. My daughter has been massive for me. Her coming, like her being born in a few months when it was that time last year, I went and saw the doctor, and this is why I couldn't get bloody life insurance, which I think is wrong, and said I'm drinking too much and I'm seeing the signs again of where I was 2 years ago, and I want to change that. I don't want to be like that in front of my daughter. Now I don't drink Mondays to Thursdays, and that was hard at first, to be honest. I definitely had addiction there, and now I work out as much as I can. And she, for me, was just like my doctor said, use this as a point of change. You know, I want to be a great role model for her, and I want to be the best I can be for her. I mean, it's true. Until you have kids, mate, as tired as I am and as much as they drive me and my wife up the wall and test our patience, they change your whole perspective, hey?
Oh, 100%, mate.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
It's life. Like you've brought a life into this world.
Mate, they're just happy. They're just, you know, she goggles away to herself and throws food, and I just think it's fucking hilarious. We blow raspberries at each other. It's great. I'm looking forward to going home to see her, you know.
I think it's awesome you're talking about that. So I don't know, I've thrown a few videos, weird videos out there in the past on my socials, but so I feel like we're afraid to be ourselves because we're all afraid of what other people are thinking. Like
yes
a child up until the age of that they start to actually recognize influence.
Yep.
They're themselves. They don't give a shit if they fart, if they shit themselves,
absolutely,
if they laugh,
mate.
Like what they say.
Absolutely.
And I think, I talk about my dog, Walter. I think animals are exactly the same.
Yeah.
Like, they are happy. Like you look at a dog.
Trick to being happy is being a dog.
Yeah, but
absolutely.
Because they don't get influenced by anyone.
No.
The problem with us now is we are so influenced by every single person around us.
Correct.
Whether that's family, friends,
yep.
social media,
yep.
Social groups, school groups,
yep.
work environment,
yep.
like we are all influenced by people.
So, you know, I think living in a city and go, 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 that fast pace, like my wife and I want to get up the coast and live a much more relaxed lifestyle. That's an issue, but social media has made a much bigger issue, especially with bullying, I hear, because kids can't actually get away from it anymore.
Yep.
Like we were able to go home and go play in the street or kick a soccer ball around and be left alone.
Oh, yeah, you gave someone a smack in the mouth and it was all said and done. Where like now it's just, it
mind
just keeps
games.
Going. Just keeps
That's
going.
It, mate. Public humiliation.
Yeah.
I suck with my big words. My lawyer wife always gets up me about that. So, I definitely agree with you there. But unfortunately, I don't think it's going to change. Technology is exponentially increasing. And this AI stuff is scary, and that's a whole nother topic, you know.
Well, I think it's even more important in the times that we're in for people to maybe think look outside the box a bit. Don't be afraid to try something new and different. Do the breathing.
Be uncomfortable.
I just, me and some mates just bloody signed up to a snowy mountain expedition. We're going to, it's 3 days of breathing, bloody breath work, ice baths, and with the goal on the third day is that we walk to the top of Mount Kosciuszko on the 3rd of June.
Yep.
So it's probably going to be like 0 degrees in our underwear.
Yep. Sounds like a terrible idea, but it would be awesome, mate.
Well,
it'll be a great bonding experience as well.
For me, it's about getting out of my comfort zone.
Yeah.
Like,
but also connecting with that group.
But so the thing with this, the young guy that does this stuff, it's all about like controlling your body with your breath.
Yeah.
Like, so your breath ultimately does control your mind.
Yes, yes. Like,
and when you get the right breathing techniques,
yeah,
it could be minus 10 degrees, but your body thinks you're hot.
Yeah, yeah. Like, mind over matter.
Yeah.
Again, you have to watch David Goggins. He's unreal.
Yeah.
So,
I know there's plenty of people around that will hear some of the stuff I say now and just like, fuck it. Like, Duayne's turned. He's like, what is he? But try new shit.
Yeah.
Get outside your comfort zone, buddy. Yeah. See how much it improves your life.
Haters are going to hate. Oh, something else you were saying before. I don't think I'm someone who's always cared very much what other people think about me. And David Goggins talks about that we all do, and you can't change that. You know how crazy he is? He takes what people said about him. He even spices it up a bit, makes a mixtape of him saying it, and he works out to it. He, mate, he's unbelievable. He's just like, he takes it too far, but it's unreal to listen to. We all care about what others think. And I think running a business, and I like being out there. I like putting my face out there. Hayden doesn't so much. The more I do it, like there's probably people who've been listening today go, oh, screw this guy, get a cup of cement. And I don't care for those people. I'm not doing this for them. I'm doing this for the people who need it, you know?
Yeah.
And I think you and I sitting here doing this in what is a very hot bloody shed today, I must say. I'm glad I wore my nice shirt. I know that's going to put good out into the world, and that makes me feel fulfilled.
So, mate, you've learned how to cope with it. You're putting some mechanism in place. You're thinking outside the box. You're trying a few new things out. Like, how have you seen the change in your life in other areas?
I think my mindset has changed. I'm just much more compassionate now and more understanding, you know. I can be a better partner. Anush has worked for me for the past 6 years and maybe one of our co-directors next year. There's a few things in the work. He said to me, I'm so proud of you. And he's younger than me. I've seen massive changes in you over the last 2 years. The way I handled the business, I don't stress them out anymore, and I'm there for them. I'm a better leader. Mate, there's so much good has come from it.
Yeah.
It really does. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
Yeah.
Mate. And I'm even just, I found that I'm more giving now. And I don't know if that's because Ryan was my mentor and he passed away and he was so giving. And I'm paying it forward. And this young guy, Jace, he Arc Lab, right? He's just started his own company, Design. And he reached out to me and said, long shot. Like, it's funny, man. He looks up to me and I was there a second ago looking up to the other guys, you know? So I catch up with him for coffees and I've helped him do his business. So it's just made me want to give more and help more. It's made me more compassionate and just a better person overall.
So it's changed how you show up.
Yeah, mate. Yes. Well, the other reason I've been here in the gym a lot is because I want to perform. I want our team to be the next Sean Lockyer. And I've built a team around me. It's not about money. It really isn't. Profit's important, obviously. But, mate, the team I have now, we've got a team of eight. Fuck, we're a solid team. Once we run, we're going to run. We just all want to get to the same place.
Yeah.
And I've realized, like, I used to work for bosses that...
You can hear your passion, mate. You can hear how passionate you are about it.
I don't know why I am so passionate about... Do you know what I mean? Like, why are you so passionate about building? Why am I so passionate about design? I don't know. It's just my thing. I think it's more for me, it's we're building something together and it gives me purpose. It gets my blood pumping when I get up in the morning, you know?
So that's the business side of it, but do you reckon it's helped you show up different to your clients as well?
I think more because of the mental health stuff I went through and having to change my business has helped me how I show up to clients. Actually, you know, one big thing, and I used to take on all their problems that weren't always my problems. Okay, so I've had a couple builders. Yeah, you know all this, mate, right?
I just think you're dropping bombs everywhere.
I need to be the
real Brad Lee and have my little bomb pushing button.
Yeah, do the effects of the crowd going off in the background. You know, a couple builders have fallen over and left my clients in very dire situations, and I feel for them, but I don't let it get me down anymore. And I used to care for things that weren't my problem, and that's what burnt me out. And I know that sounds harsh. But, man, you got your own life to live at the same time.
It's not harsh, mate.
No.
Like, I used to think the exact same thing. And I think that's another thing we stress out about, because we think that someone else is going to think, oh, fuck, you're an arsehole. Like, why don't you care? Like, why aren't you doing anything about that? But I can't control everything. No, you can't control everything. Like, and it's other people need to make their own decisions.
And like we said before, people will take advantage of us and make and think that their priority is our priority because we're nice people.
Yeah, and then I think it's it's funny when you get through, like when you get through all this stuff, like you have and I have, and you come out the other side, and you can like it's we can sit here and talk about things, but and it sort of does make me laugh now because I think, man, people were telling me that for so long, and I didn't bloody listen to them.
Like, well, you didn't understand.
Yeah,
that's you know you didn't
because when you
didn't believe it would work.
Yeah, so talking about like making everyone else's problem your problems.
Yeah.
A silly little thing just snowballs. Yep. Like you take on a client mentions something to you.
Yep. Yep.
You want to save the world, so you take it on, and then all of a sudden that little thing has grown. That's affected something else, and that's affected something else, and that's affected something else. And before you know it, it's cost you a shitload of time, a shitload of money.
Yep.
And they're still not happy.
Correct. Oh, mate, there's some clients that you cannot please everybody, and that's something else I had to learn the hard way. I blocked a couple numbers, to be honest, because they were just taking, and I could not do anything right for them, no matter how much I busted my ass. Not taking on people's problems as well. That listen, if you're my client and you have a problem on site, I will be there, okay? But if something comes up that's out of my control, like a builder, past what my work, I've done the best I can, and a builder screws them over. All I can do is hear them out, but I'm not going to wear that for the rest of my day because I used to take on everyone's stress.
Yeah. Look, mate, at the end of the day, you're the designer. Like, you can't, you're not forcing anyone's hand to say, hey, build with this builder, or you don't know the builder's financial situation, or all like COVID, weather, all that shit.
Yep.
Like, you do design, you do a great job at it.
Thanks.
And then they take over.
Yeah. Absolutely,
mate. They need to make their own decisions.
I used to get pulled into it all the time, and it wasn't really about it wasn't about the money. It was more the time and the stress that it added to my life. And again, it was affecting close people around me when it shouldn't have been.
Yeah.
My wife has always said I'm too nice of a person. You know, pessimist lawyer. She's a lovely person, but she taught me you got to have tougher skin. So, yeah, mate, I've changed a lot in the last few years, and I look forward to how will I change more. I just hope that the lessons don't come as harsh as they did in the past.
But it's incredible, mate, once you start to see how all this shit works. And, like, again, back in the day, I would have thought, like, man, you're talking shit. Like, that's all woo-woo. Doesn't happen. Whatever.
Yep.
But it does. Like, you start doing these little small things, and it just starts to snowball and everything starts to fall into place. And, and like people talk about like, he's just lucky. Oh shit. Everything just happens to him.
It's bullshit.
It's all bullshit.
It's like, bullshit.
Luck happens because you make it happen.
Yeah. Like you make your own luck.
Yeah. Like something you've like doing your breath work or taking ownership or taking responsibility starts creating luck.
Something else that people need to do in business more is not let emotion get involved. And I've always been good at this, but I've seen other bosses get terrible with it. I had a guy quit recently, and he's going on a different career path, not that because he wants to, but because I can't match the money. And I get it right now. He wants to get in the housing market. Man, I just sat down with him as a friend, and I said, I get it. And I hope you come back, and I've loved having you, and I wish you all the best. I've seen other bosses take that the complete opposite way. And all that's doing to them is adding unnecessary stress and emotion to their day.
Oh, mate, I probably shouldn't get started on this one, but I think people actually need to start taking some personal responsibility and stop living beyond their means.
Yes.
Like just because you choose to live one way doesn't mean that me as a boss should have to pay for it.
Yeah.
Like if interest rates are going up, fucking stop eating out 3 or 4 nights or five nights a week. Or, like everyone, correct. Like I don't know, you're a bit younger than me, but like that, like the days of like a first homeowner moving into the fibro cottage and being happy with the 2 bedrooms and an eat out.
Yes,
like,
yes.
Everyone wants
they want
4 bedrooms, 3 bathrooms, double garage, pool in the backyard, fully landscaped.
Yep.
And then on top of that, they want 2 new cars. They want all new furniture. Yep. They want to eat out 4 nights a week.
Yep.
Like,
and they want
take leftovers for lunch. Mm-hmm. Like, you cook your dinner the night before and you save your leftovers. Like, I could go all day about that one. People need to take responsibility and stop living beyond their means and expecting employers.
Yes.
Because one thing that all these people don't understand is we can all pay them more means our prices go up, which means they have to pay more for everything.
Yes, but also it's more...
That's a whole other podcast.
Oh, mate, I know I can go down. It's more risk and stress on you as well as a boss, you know? Mate, I completely agree with you.
Mate, these people that are whinging that like every month or whatever that their payments are going up for $300.
Well,
like that's two nights out.
Yeah,
don't go out.
Yeah,
stay at
sure,
home.
Sure.
Buy some groceries.
What I'm also seeing, I love seeing both sides, both perspectives. Right, I completely agree. But what I'm also seeing is like with construction prices moving, that my clients over the last 2 years had no. They may have locked themselves into a situation which changed so quickly and they had to build and take that extra finance and now it's moved on them.
Yeah.
I feel for that.
Yeah,
I
feel for that.
I get that.
I feel for that.
But I agree. And I think for most people, it's from social media and they want everything yesterday. Honestly, my dad it always made me wholesome of you have to enjoy the journey, not the destination. Chris Clout is where I want to be and he lives in my dream fucking house on the ocean, right? But I'm not stressed that we're similar age and he's there because that to me goes, it's achievable. I can get there and I'm going to enjoy every day towards it.
Yeah. Oh, mate, it took me a long time to realize that. Like, if you're not happy with where you are right now, what makes you think you're going to be happy when you get to there? Because when you get to there, you're going to want to get to there. And then when you get to there, you're going to want to get to there.
Grass is always greener.
Yeah. Like, you have to be happy.
Yeah.
I think that, like, mentally for me, that was a really big one.
Yep.
Like, just thinking, right. Fuck everybody else. Yep. I'm happy with where I am. I'm happy with what I got. Yep. I don't need that shit.
Like, I think that's something that, from what I've heard from my mates, really happens in your 30s as well. You would just realize that there's more to busting your ass. Like,
maybe once you have kids.
Yeah, possibly. Well, not many people in our group actually really have kids, but we've all just kind of calmed. We used to party a lot, to be honest. So we got a party crowd, but we've all calmed down a lot. And life gets tough, you know, especially when you're an adult, you get a lot more responsibilities. It's funny, just quickly with my team, right? I've really noticed that the 20 to 25 year olds, they're just living happy, right? I don't care what I get paid. I'm living happy and got a good job. Sweet. I'm going to go get drunk on the weekend, all weekend, and rock up Monday fine. And then they get 25 to 30 and they're like, where am I going? Hey, boss, where am I going? And then you get to my age and I think for me now, it's more about fulfillment than money. You know, money is important. My wife and I have big dreams and we have a child to look after. But yeah, it's just funny. And I can't wait to see, like, how old are you now, Duayne?
42.
42, yep. I thought maybe 34, 1 year off. I'll have to get a few grays in my beard, mate, to catch up to you. But I'm sure, mate, even since in, you know, those 10 years that you've seen even more change in yourself.
And mate, I've changed and achieved everything that I ever thought I would achieve in probably the last 5 or 6 years.
Yep.
Like, before that, it was just that that roller coaster ride. You're up, you're down, you're up, you're down. Yes. What do I do? I'm depressed. Yes. I got anxiety.
Yes.
Oh, we won a job. Sweet. Yep. Like, it was just ran in circles.
What you helping people has no doubt made you feel more fulfilled.
And again, like, it comes back to what we were saying before, like, once you get on this path, like, it all just snowballs.
Yeah. It falls into place.
Yeah. Like, and mate, that's why I like to tell my story, because I literally took 34 to 36 years to start making this all fall into place.
Yes.
So there was a lot of years of shit to get to where I am.
And if people listening that are younger take it on board and stick to it, like a set of rules, it will come quicker.
Well, mate, that's why I love doing this. I love what you're doing. I love that it's getting spoken about now. People, like, I'm on a mission now to chat, like, create a new industry. Like, I don't care what other people think. Like, I know that if anything, the haters drive me. Like, I love people saying to me,
mate,
what are you fucking doing, mate? You're never going to create a new industry. Like, give up. Nah, I'm like, mate, you've just inspired me to go even
harder. Mate. They think it's impossible, you know.
Yeah.
There's a lot of people out there, and it's their own lives, but I think it's sad that they don't think that they can do great or make change, but you really can.
Yeah.
I'm starting to see it more and more, you know, just in what, you know, I wish Ryan was here, but in what we built and what I built with Hayden, man, like, it just makes me so fucking proud.
So where's it going? Where's MR going?
Okay, so we got big moves coming. Hayden is having a kid right now. He's very selfish, like I was last year. So I pissed off for a month, and now it's his turn. Okay, so we have been quiet. The last, I think, 3 months up to Christmas was a quiet turnover had been in quite a while, since COVID, pretty much, since we had the bigger team. And every... I talk to a lot of my competitors, I think, and you probably do the same. I think that's important. There's enough work out there. They all found the exact same. all of a sudden, mate, it's
don't call them competitors, mate.
Competitors, don't, what do you call them? Friends, colleagues.
Colleagues, mate.
Yeah, yeah.
We're all in this together.
Yeah, very true. So, you know, talking to them, like I talked to Dane from Coda, Melissa from Concepts Unlimited, her and I have become close recently, JMH, I catch up with heaps of them. And I just love it. It's, you know, you're talking to people that are passionate about the same thing. Anyway, so the business is starting to pick up. We're seeing, as I did a story, I think a week or two ago on our socials, we're seeing that all of a sudden a lot of concept work is coming through. Now, not many people are building right now. And you, I don't know if you're seeing the same because you do have a really good name for yourself, but I think also there's going to be in a couple months, a few months, a bit of a gap that we saw. Okay. Yeah. But until interest rates start rising, then I think it's just going to boom. Did you go to a HIA thing, that event?
No, I've been going to hit some mass builder stuff.
But yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Look, I don't know. I think I've been around the traps long enough now. Like again, don't listen to the media. Don't believe anything that's getting sold, told out there. Look, the lower end, I think, is going to struggle. Like what we just talked about. Everyone has extended there. They're living beyond their means.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
I'm a firm believer, mate, that in these situations, this is when people with real money come out.
Yes.
And so if you position yourself well, you do a good job, you look after people, the people that actually have money, cash, they might need a little bit of finance or maybe no finance.
Yep.
This is where they'll rock on.
This is what we're seeing as well. Yeah. All our developers and clients with the cash are all pushed into construction right now because they know it's when they get ahead.
Yeah.
And it's a bit sad. The rich get richer, but most people are self-made and good on them. And as long as they stay humble people, you know. Yeah, I know what you're saying. I think maybe being a younger guy, I'm seeing a lot of like, mate, how the hell are 20-year-olds going to get into the Brisbane market?
But it's... I don't know, mate. Again, it's just, I'm so open-minded now. Like, I used to be on that bandwagon, the rich get richer. They don't get richer. Like,
no.
They just are smarter and they've learnt more and they do more and get some pieces. But a 20-year-old trying to get in the market, like, I actually pulled myself up on this because leading up to Christmas, I was starting to think, like, how the hell are my kids going to get a house?
Yeah.
And I've pulled myself up and I've stopped saying it because... Like, man, my parents said that when they got a house, like,
and they
40
made
years
it work.
Ago. They made it work.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I believe there's big change coming.
Yeah.
I think everyone, because things are sort of getting spoken about as being a bit tough, I think, I don't believe building has gotten more expensive. Like, building has increased in price since the very first fucking cave ever dug out.
Yeah, very true.
Like, so building will always continue to
of
grow.
Course,
there's going to be spikes and there's going to be level periods.
Yep.
And so people just have to, like, I believe what's made it really bad or what has made people think it's really bad at the moment is people's wish lists have got bigger.
Yeah, absolutely.
So people can still have a really good product for a reasonable amount of money.
Yes, yes.
It's just... Expectations need to be pulled back.
It's going
to
look like you're schooling the young guy, mate, on stop with the smash avo. No, talking to my grandma, like, you know, they talked about where they were living paycheck to paycheck when dad was young, and they, like, every 2 months bought a bottle of wine.
Mm.
Mate, I'll buy a bottle of wine any bloody time I want.
Yeah.
And my granddad said he reckons there's too many traps.
Yeah.
Just right now with social media and ads in your face and wanting to get ahead and seeing other people get ahead and wanting to compete. I don't know why the fuck you'd bother, honestly. I want a nice house. I want a nice lifestyle for my family.
I think a great example, mate, of where society is at the moment is have a look on social media at how many companies are making a shitload of money giving shit away.
Yeah, yeah.
Like how many entrepreneurs are there at the moment?
The boats and all the houses.
Yeah, giving away a four-driving caravan or four-driving a boat.
Yeah, I chuck $30 on one and I don't have a boat.
But, like, they're booming because people are looking for that, like...
The easy fix. Do you know how many people I speak to that are like, oh, no, I plan on winning the lotto? It's like, fuck off. Do you know the odds? Do you know what probability is?
Yeah.
I don't know. I try to not get wrapped in it. Up in it too much too, and I think that's where a lot of my anxiety and depression came from, is that I got caught up in it.
It was mine.
Yeah.
That was a big part of why I got caught in
it. And comparing other people and your age or running their own business and comparing. Like, a lot of people look up to me and, like, friends have been like, fuck, I wish I'd had a successful business. But I said to them, you got to realize I look up too and I think down on myself because there's always a bigger fish.
Yeah.
We need to look down. It's relativity, my dad says.
Yeah. So something that I've really been focused on lately, I actually did an American sort of mentorship type thing a couple of months ago, which had some really, really big players in it. And some of the things that got discussed in there really, I've just been sitting on and thinking. Mm-hmm. And one of them was, like, we are all individuals.
Yeah.
Like every single one of us is our own person.
Yep.
And we should recognize that that's okay.
Yes.
And so everyone learns differently. Whether you've got the headspace to go and have a cracking business when you're 20, or whether it takes you to your 40s to be that person.
Yes. Yes.
That's okay.
Yeah.
We're all different.
Yeah, absolutely. And people should know that even though I started business young and it's going well, I still have plenty of days where I feel behind the eight ball and get down on myself.
Yeah.
But, mate, then I go home and I see Sim and Bella, and what's any of it matter, you know?
Yeah.
So, yeah. Well,
mate, I actually feel like we could continue talking for hours.
Good D&M.
Like, it's, it's, and I think, mate, seriously, there's been some incredible information.
Yep.
And I do. I mean it when I take my hat off to you for reaching out and, like...
Oh, my pleasure.
I think, like... I got off the phone after you made that call, and like I literally ran Shay straight away and said, mate, just ring him, get him in here. Like for someone to...
I was wondering if you were thinking like, how much is he actually going to open up? Do you know what I mean?
No, I said to Shay, it'll be a good one.
Yeah, like, could tell I was ready to be...
Well, you wouldn't have asked.
Yeah.
Like you wouldn't have asked if you didn't. And mate, I only hope by you coming on here, I know you've added a lot of value. I know you've probably helped save a life today.
Fucking hope so.
But I also know that by you doing this, there's nothing to be ashamed of, and your business will thrive because of this.
Yeah, but it's not why I'm here.
No, I know that.
I know.
It's going like, but you doing this without you may be realizing it yet.
Yes. No,
You're going to attract clients that are on the same page as you.
So someone who taught me, I was speaking to Shay about this before we started, Peter Charles, who's a good friend of mine, and you've had her, and she taught me to just be who you are.
Yeah.
And, mate, being genuine is the best way to attract clients.
Yeah.
People want people, you know?
And when you attract, mate, that is the perfect client. When you attract people that are similar to you and believe in you.
Mm-hmm. Oh, mate. Trust, mate. A client who trusts you to do a good job. I just had a beautiful home built in Nunda, and instead of doing a rectangle, I convinced them, let's do an L shape, and they love it. I said, just like, they're so thankful. I'm like, mate, thank you for trusting me to show you what I can do. Mate, it's been a pleasure. The last thing that I do want to talk about is where the business is going, and that's not why I'm here.
No, listen, if
the exposure is great, I'm a big believer that what you give out into the universe is what you receive.
Yeah.
And I know that good things will come my way because I've put out this positivity today. The business, when Hayden gets back and things look to ramp up again, we're going to be rebranding to Michael and Roosh. So we're going to still be MR Designs. Now, this has been a hard decision because it was Michael and Ryan. And Ryan's been gone 3.5 years. But Hayden has really been my business partner for 5. And it's not that he really cares about it. It's just that I think he should have the right to have his name on it. Okay, so too many people think it's just my business, and that's just not true. We also want to go more high-end. You know, as you've heard many times, I want to be the next Sean Lockyer, Chris Clout, whoever. Michael and Roosh, I hope,
it's unreal, man.
A few years to come is the next thing. Well, why not dream big?
Mate, so, shit, we are going to talk all day. Mate, you got to dream.
Like, absolutely.
And another thing, that our dreams
are... It's meaning.
Our dreams are another thing that's... depressed by the way we're brought up.
Yeah.
Like, oh, you work too hard. Oh, you can't have that. Oh, you'll never have that. Yeah. Oh, you can't afford that. Like, fuck that. Like,
I found turning away from listening to all that shit. Yeah. Like, I don't watch the news.
Yeah.
Just turning away from all of that.
Yeah.
It just helps you recenter on what you want to do and being yourself.
Just quickly on goals. Do you write goals down?
No, but I definitely have them mentally.
Oh, mate, you got to write them down.
Oh, nah, mate, you sound like my old man.
You got to write them down.
I have inspirational quotes written down.
Yeah.
Like, I've got one on my computer that says, you'll get through this like you always get through it.
Yeah.
And that has helped me, or one day at a time. Goals, I think it might be different. And
well, sure, goals or vision. Like,
just long term, let's get to be one of the big guys, you know, and that's a part of improving our service. So the team I have now, documentation, is something I've never had a great interest in, but is super important, as you as a builder would know.
Yeah.
So I brought on a couple of great guys for that, and I'm really pushing myself to do that animation work.
Yeah.
My animator, we're going to be bringing out prettier pictures. You know, we want to hit that gel ad set level. I know a couple of guys that work there and work at Grayer, and the stuff they do is just awesome. So our goals is to just keep improving our service, and we've used this quiet period as a really good time to build those systems and do things we've been talking about. You know, the one really big thing for my business, and I know we're going to go on and we'll finish on this. Hayden and I, we were really like, we kept our goals to ourselves and we didn't tell anyone the numbers in the business. Now, I have a senior meeting after my Monday team meeting with six of our team who are all seniors. And we look at the numbers and we talk about goals and we throw ideas and we brainstorm, and it brought us all together and brought us all in. And that has just been the best thing, mate.
Yeah. Because they feel a part of it.
And they should be.
Yeah.
They should be.
Yeah.
The way you're going to keep your team and build towards something great is by working along with their goals. And if you can't, that's okay. You shake their hand and you wish them best of luck. And you keep going with the people who see the same vision as you. Mate, that's my goal. I don't have to be honest right now, mate, I've got a kid at home. Like, my wife is probably waiting for me to get home and give her a break, you know? But I'm always thinking about, where do we want to take this? And Hayden and I, we have a phone chat each week to talk about that.
So is that, we'll wrap it up, mate. Is that all you want to say about the business, like the name change? And
yeah, there might be other things in the work to come in the next year or so, but we'll see how that goes first. And I tend to give everything away too early. But the reason for the name change is to be a bit more exclusive and push towards those high-end projects. And honestly, it's not about the money for us. It's just because we love to do that.
That's what you want to do.
It's our passion. Yeah. I fucking love it. Mate, going to a construction site is the best shit ever. Like, I'm sure blokes look at me like, oh, he's a fucking designer. But I love it, mate. And I love learning from you guys. I know how to design and I know how to use all the computer programs. But being a senior and running my own business, I've had such an appreciation for what you guys do. Like, I busted my thumb trying to build a gate at my house, you know? And no, I respect the craftsmanship, you know? It's a different type of craftsmanship, so.
Yeah, no, respect's mutual, mate. It's got to go both ways.
But, yeah.
Mate, look, again, take my hat off to you. Thanks so much. I feel like 12 months, we're going to have you back again. We're going
to
see where this goes.
Yeah,
Thanks very much for watching, everyone. Look, as usual, if you love what we chat about, make sure you subscribe, like, comment, all those types of things, and look forward to seeing you on the next one. Everything discussed during the Level Up podcast with me, Duayne Pierce, is based solely on my own personal experiences and those experiences of my guests. The information, opinions, and recommendations presented in this podcast are for general information only, and any reliance on the information provided in this podcast is done at your own risk. We recommend that you obtain your own professional advice in respect to the topics discussed during this podcast.